How much are you selling minced beef for, please?
$2.99 a kilo, sir.
$2.99 a kilo?
Yep.
It's very competitive. Could you just hold on 2 seconds, please? Just got to take another call. Won't be a second.
This is a customer announcement. This is a customer announcement. Morrison's are pleased to announce that our minced beef is now at 99p per kilo. That's 99 pence per kilo, over £2 cheaper than your high street butcher. Thank you.
Hello?
Genius.
Thank you.
So you are the phone jacker.
I am the phone jacker.
How do we know it is really you?
You don't know it's really me. No, you do.
If you don't do Terry Tibbs, you're not the phone jacker.
I'll do Terry for you now.
Yes! Right?
Can we have the
Sock who I am. Talk to me. I never see it. Don't think I will again. Thanks for having me on.
That clip of the second series, right, starts on E4 in a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Was it harder the second time around? Because people kind of knew... You know, we'd listen, pick the phone up and go, that's Terry Tibbs, isn't it?
Yeah. I make so many phone calls that probably out of the 3,000 that I made for the second series, maybe 4 or 5 were like, oh, is that George? Ah, it's George, is it? No, sir, I don't know what you're talking about. Because I never break character, so if they're like, oh, that's George, you're the phone jacker, innit? I'm like, no, I just simply require your bank account details. So. I'm a cruise missile, you know, I just gotta go.
Because I used to try and do prank phone calls on radio, and I was rubbish. It's quite hard, isn't it, to like kind of keep a straight face and all that kind of stuff?
Yeah, I mean, if you're in character, then you're in character, and you're not doing it for laughs, you're just doing it to have fun. But I rarely crack up because I've got so many calls to get. You know, the producer's like, how many calls you done today, son? You know, we got deadlines, we got a budget. You know,
so you like what? Get a big book of phone numbers. Yeah, the phone book, and just go, right, I've got to do 100 today, and I'm going to do.
Yeah,
this.
I got phone books. I get on the internet, Gumtree, you know, ads and stuff.
Do you get the idea? Do you have the ideas and then look for the people, or do you scan adverts and stuff and then think, well, we could have a joke with that person and then make something up?
Yeah, I mean, some adverts just, you know, really pop out, like, you know, flat to rent, for example. You know.
You just set that, that's really like, different.
Looking for a flat, is that great? You know, oh, I've got a very nice apartment for you. You know.
obviously, you can't, you can script stuff, but only to a certain extent, because you never know what people are going to say back to you. Because, oh, what was the one we were killing ourselves yesterday in the office? The bungalow was the one we were killing ourselves.
Sorry.
A bungalow. No, with the providing, the internet.
Internet service providing.
Internet service providing. And the bloke made you say it 3 times. Mm. And you said it back to him 3 times. So have you got some of it written down?
No. No. I mean, I know it looks like we've got scripting, but no.
So you don't... I tell you what, you're so quick then, that you don't have any notes, nothing to bail
nothing
you out.
Nothing at all.
Just
a glass
brilliant.
Of water, you know. It's very hot in there, so you could stand.
You called Kidderminster Harry once.
Yeah. I call up Kidderminster Harry, right? It's early in the morning. I just had a cup of tea, just rolled out of bed. I'm just wearing my pants, right?
Like Bobby.
So I try to buy Kidderminster Harriers, but I speak to some bungling secretary. He's like, no, he's not here, right? The chairman's not in. So who is this? Terry Tibbs. Who? Forget it.
So that one didn't make the show. It didn't make the show.
It's just one of the thousands that don't make the show.
So you could now try and phone it up as a Russian billionaire, try and buy.
I've done a few Russian calls,
somebody.
Actually. A few Russian oligarchs, yes. You know. Yeah. You get very aggressive on the phone, you know. But
do you know what? Maybe this whole Man City thing is a scam. Was it you?
It was.
Yeah! They've got no money.
I would like to buy Manchester City.
Right. We'll have a chat about football and other stuff later. The phone jacker! Every